Hey, it's Cooking with John. How are you doing today? You know how I usually just make stuff up, but sometimes I run across a recipe that's on the internet and I want to try it. My friend Geraldine Womack has posted another good recipe. Today, we're going to make salmon patties.
It's Cooking with John.
Okay, first of all, I'm going to have to cut up some stuff. So let's get an onion. We need about a quarter cup of onion. So first of all, I got to chop this thing up. This is probably more than I need. But I'll use some of this for something else. I need a quarter cup. This is a half cup measure, so I'm going to fill this halfway. I need a quarter cup of finely diced onion. So I'm going to use the finer stuff that's here till I get the right amount of measure here. There's about a quarter cup. And I'll put that in a bowl. Give me that skin. Give me some skin! This goes in here. For the time being. Next, we want to open up the salmon, so we need to get it drained nicely. All right. Well, you missed it. I drained the tuna and then I crushed it all up nice and I added the onions. So okay, so we'll resume now. So let's see. Okay, we need a quarter cup of onion finely chopped. We need a quarter cup of cornmeal and a quarter cup of flour. A quarter cup of flour in here. Okay, and a quarter cup of cornmeal. Like that. 3 tablespoons of mayonnaise.
So there's like 1, 2, 3.
Pretty close anyway. By the way, that's real mayonnaise. What else do we need? We need an egg.
Yeah, eggy.
Don't egg me on. 1 chicken egg. 1 chicken egg. Don't use seagull eggs because seagull eggs taste like fish.
I need fish.
You got that right. And I don't use salmon eggs either because I'd be cracking eggs all day. They're so little. Yeah, I believe what I just said. Actually, there's something that bothers me about caviar. If it's so good, why does it have to go on a cracker? I mean, everything's good when it sits on a Ritz. If you think I'm cool now, wait until I find a cracker that's the size that fits. I'm sitting on a Ritz. If you eat too much chocolate and you're running and you find out you got... Now I'm going to add a couple more things that are, it'll be non-invasive, but you know, be good. Here's some white pepper and a little lemon pepper. Come in. Oh, that was me. Well, that's a lot of lemon pepper. Okay, so that, all right, that'll work. I'm going to add a little bit of flax seed. Okay, flax seed is very healthy for you. So we're going to add about a tablespoon of flax seed. Nobody will ever know. Flavorless and nutritious. That's awesome, isn't it? Okay, now let's get something to stir this mess up with. Okay. We've got a nice consistency here that sticks together like that. See that? Nice. We'll be able to make patties out of that. No problem. I want to make sure it's well blended. It smells great. Okay, that part's ready. Now, I want to work on a sauce for it. Okay, saucepan. But before we do this, I want to cut up this stuff. We're going to make a very cool vegetable side dish that you've never seen before in your life. So, I'm going to cut up some of this stuff. Go to a commercial.
Brush your teeth with it. Wipe your seat with it. Eat it on spaghetti. Farthingay, farthingay.
Fresh and swift. Opens jars. Mows the lawn. Washes cars. Keeps giraffes and cows away. Farthingay, farthingay.
Farthingay, the do-everything stuff, comes in burlap bag, spray applicator, 50-gallon drum, or canister set. Get yours today.
Farthingay, farthingay.
Now it's time for the John Show to come on door. Everybody sit down, shut up, and watch.
Okay, this is probably the oddest lineup of vegetables you ever saw in your life. What we have here is sliced radishes, some cabbage, some onions, and purslane. What is purslane? That's this stuff. I got it out of my driveway. I've been cooking with it for the last week or two. And you would not believe it's one of the most healthy plants in the world. Maybe I can show you a picture of exactly where I got it, if I can find one. But anyway, so this is gonna be our vegetables. Now I'm gonna cook this with some olive oil. And some sesame oil. The sesame oil is for flavor. The olive oil is for cooking. But we're going to flavor it with sesame oil. All right. That's ready for the stove. Now let's work on the sauce. The sauce is going to consist of slivered almonds. And I'm going to cut these up a little more. These are Mexican jumping slivered almonds. Okay, that's good enough. Put those in the pan, like that. Now this is going to get cooked with some butter. Let's go to the stove. Okay, we've got our vegetables over here. Over there we've got our saucepan, which is going to start doing some butter. And then up front here, we're going to be doing our patties. I'll just switch pans around to the burners, like I did before. That seemed to work pretty good. So first of all, I'm going to get this butter melted in and get these started to toasting. Now I'll put these vegetables over here and just stir them around a little bit so that we can get the oil moved all around all over the vegetables. And that can start cooking. Okay, let's move that over here. Now let's start making the patties. First of all, we're going to need some oil. Okay, gotta have a good amount of oil here to get these patties going. Okay, let's start making patties. Make a patty about that big, about the size of a burger, and we'll gently place it in the oil. I'm not sure how many I'm gonna get out of this. Oh, maybe a half a dozen. Now, I bet these would be good in sandwiches, but for this recipe, we're gonna be eating these on with some sauce. Oh man, these smell outrageously good without even being cooked. Probably because of the mayonnaise. I mean, it reminds me of just a regular tuna salad. But there are eggs in here, so want to be cool about that. We don't want to be messing with uncooked egg. Okay, I'm going to make a couple smaller ones too. That way there will actually be six. I didn't say they were all going to be the same size. Okay, but there's still a good glob left in here, which I will administer to this here small one in the middle. Okay, these have to cook and become crispy before we flip them. That is a must-do thing. These are going to need to speed up in cooking a little bit. Now I want to add
a little bit of pepper.
Smelling good. Is that the strangest looking combination of vegetables you ever saw? I'll tell you what. I don't even know what it's going to taste like. I've never done this before. It's brand new. Brand spanking new. Like it never had been spanked before. Cream of celery soup. And I'm going to dribble in the juice from the garlic. Oh, that's going to be good. You're going to believe that. Get that stirred around good. Okay. These are ready to flip. Carefully take some tongs. Oh, don't they look good? Awesome. That looks so good. Oh man, these are gonna be dynamite. Okay, back to the sauce. I'm going to also add the rest of this Parmesan cheese. There ain't much of it. And that ought to give it a nice flavor. Let's see how these are doing. These look good. These look good. Okay. Put these again. Oh, that's going to be good. It looks like it's wrapping up here. Stuff's getting pretty good here. Okay, let's see how these are doing. Those are looking good. Yeah, they need a little more time to get them the same color on top as they are on the bottom. So, all right, man, we're about ready to plate this stuff up. I'm excited. I'm going to get my big plate. Okay, let's see if these are done. Another minute. I want to make sure they're done. The sauce is done. The veggies are done. Oh, look at that. That looks good. Okay, these are done. So let's get them on a plate to drain. Okay, let's get a couple of here on the plate. Take a big one, little one. Get a few vegetables. Don't those look awesome? And of course, a little bit of sauce on this. You're not going to believe it. Doesn't that look good? Looks awesome. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's see. Let's find out. First of all, I'm going to try some without the sauce on it, just to get a taste of the original recipe. So, here's that. That's very good. Very good. Okay, now let's get some with the sauce on it. The sauce has garlic and butter and cream of celery soup. Very good. Okay. Now let's try the vegetables. introduce salt and flour first. Cleanse the palate, cleanse the palate. Okay. See what we got here. Little radish, little cabbage, little onion, little purslane. A little more than that. Let's try that again. That's good. Too good to waste. My table is clean, by the way. Man, those are good. What a weird combination. And such good flavor. That's really, really good. And the salmon patties are delicious. Oh my gosh. This is so good. You know what? It's breakfast time again. For me. What time is it? 10 to 3. It's not uncommon for my cooking show to be my breakfast too. You have to try this recipe. All of it. Go out in your yard and look for some purslane. I'm going to continue using that until I run out. Maybe not every show, but I'm not going to make purslane pie or anything. Yeah, maybe. Okay, this is mostly the original recipe, but I did add some almonds. I added some lemon pepper. And I added some flaxseed, which you can't even tell. But the flaxseeds are very healthy for you. And so is the purslane. I cannot stress it enough. The purslane is extremely good for you. And it's tasty. Good stuff. It's a garden weed. But there's a lot of stuff out there in the garden that's highly nutritious and edible. And medicinal too. You bet. Okay, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Share me with your friends. And have a great day. Bye.